It's a pleasure to be here in this interaction, which is focusing on data center and most importantly, government is up a data center, right? So we know the kind of transactions that we had been seeing scaled up in India, right? The volume and velocity at which it is happening, right? And we all are talking digitization and what that means to data center technology and more importantly, the things that it brings to data center basically. And what it brings to cybersecurity is something that I would like to talk about. So if you look at the technology, where it is now and where it will go from now, right? So if you look at infrastructure, we are in the age of edge computing, distributed computing, service mesh, intelligent platform, software defined, anything, cloud computing and infrastructure, which is now because of ransomware, we are going for immutable infrastructure, serverless, network ecosystem is also significantly rising. So we are currently going to almost 2 terabyte per second kind of a speed of network. We are working towards different ways of internet and connected access, apart from the MPLS and typical way basically. Applications are changing quite significantly. Modernization of applications is happening. Hardware system, we are now currently already we are at 3 nanometer kind of a processor speed. Eventually we'll go to the 2 nanometer, 1.4 nanometer speed in some time, and the hardware ecosystem is changing quite significantly. We are now already talking about neuromorphic computing, cognitive radio, systems on chip, the chiplets, a lot of those ecosystem, and especially because of AI, entire hardware for computing is becoming so significantly important basically, right? IoT, the devices that are connecting to network, the things that are connecting to the network and the kind of traffic that will bring it to the network, the effort all across going on AI, the entire networking ecosystem, the payment transaction system, the digital workplace, which is becoming more decentralized, more hybrid, and overall, all this is being done in a such a way that the consumer experience is significantly improved, right? So what all this talks about is it's a volume of the things that are getting developed and deployed, right? The transaction, the speed at which transactions are growing, the scale at which the transactions are significantly rising, basically. And they bring immense level of workload to data centers in the modern age, basically. And the data centers are somehow grappling to really satisfy or probably serve this workloads which is coming from all across basically. So these technologies are in a way devising and driving the story of digitization. We have to really look at what do we mean by digitization. So we try to put together a kind of understanding of digitization. So digitization, when we talk about largely digitization means 3 things basically. So we are improving the consumer experience. Most of the applications, most of the things that we have been trying to do to improve the experience of the consumer. By that process, we are also improving our own productivity. And also we are trying to find new possibilities basically. So innovation, productivity, and experience of consumer becomes very important part. But if during that, what is really happening is that each product and service is becoming more data enriched basically, right? We are designing for the mobility and new devices, basically. We are bringing more open data ecosystem. We are bringing a lot of third-party APIs and third-party interfaces in the system, basically. We are going for decompose level of service. Every service is decomposed to such a microservices, basically. We are going for platformization technology. Because of AI, we are going for event-driven architecture. We are going for now, from now, we are going for intent-based computing, basically, right? And all that has been leveraging the core technology that we track at the Data Security Council of India, 27 different type of technology. AI, ML, hardware, blockchain, IoT, networking, the cloud computing, the mobility, drone, AR, VR, basically the robotics, basically. And what is happening in that ecosystem is most of these technologies are physical in nature. And because of this technology, because of the standards, protocols and technology standards and interfaces, basically, we are able to use them. We are able to connect with them. We are able to create digitization, digital avatars of those technologies, basically, and making use of those technology for digitization, basically. So So all this technology, because of protocol technology, standard interfaces and cloud architecture and some of the architectural effort that being put together, the digitization is possible. And the digitization means that, that's I tried to explain that at the bottom of this particular slide. But what it leads basically is the significant rise in quantum and complexity of data that we are collecting basically, right? What it leads is basically the volume and velocity of the things that are getting developed and deployed is significantly rising, right? The heterogeneous devices connecting to the network, the cloud dependencies is rising basically, the different protocols and interfaces, because the things are going more physical in nature, that's why we talk about cyber physical, or sometimes we talk about digital. A lot of physical systems which are coming to digital ecosystem. So those protocol interfaces which are meant largely for the closed network are getting exposed to internet. There is high volume of data that is getting transferred and exchanged over the network and overall internet. And because of that, high volume of data is getting exchanged all across, within the country and outside the country as well. So digitization means starting with this experience, productivity and possibility, a lot of things which goes as an underlying part of the digitization ecosystem basically. And when we talk about this, what it basically brings to the table and to us is that every organization, be it a small SME or be it a big organization, a transition processing, be it a oil energy sector kind of organization, everybody is now trying to make sure that new ideas are thought early, the entire idea in terms of and getting those ideas to deploy on digital space, that development speed is significantly now getting reduced, and this is how the entire digitization is evolving, right? And from this digitization, you have to really look at one important thing which is going to happen and which will be changing the data center technology quite significantly. From now onwards, we are going into three different computing coming together. So that's the bit, like for example, a semiconductor ecosystem that would be still serving our needs, and the bit would be playing important role. But we also know that at this point of time, there is quantum computers which is coming in basically, right? And that's computing is called qubit computing. And there are some people and all across that has been built on a neuromorphic computing basically. Brain-inspired computing is also coming in basically. So this hybrid computing, which nowadays, people are building data centers for hybrid computing ecosystem. They're building computing so that the workload, whether it is coming to you, that workload, depending on the nature of the workload, it can be sent to the quantum computer, it can be sent to the neuron computing, or if it is deep learning kind of protocol, it can be sent to that, or if it is conventional workload, it can be sent to that basically. So this hybrid computing environment is where the most of the data center ecosystem will evolve in the coming 3-4 years of time basically. They will be leveraging this computing available to us, and this computing especially, and there will be amalgamation of these different kind of computing technologies basically. And some of us know what do you mean by quantum computing, some of us know probably what do you mean by neuromorphic computing basically, and we conventionally know about the semiconductor computing as well. And they all will be changing, they all be shaping the way the data center technology will be evolving from now basically. So in this ecosystem basically, we at the Data Security Council of India is trying to see what could be the security for such environment, right? Which are those areas that we should be building security? Which are those areas that we should be probably thinking about security? And that those efforts that we are putting together, and those efforts bring down to us to think about these possibilities, and these will be very important possibilities and priorities for the future for security. Let's look at them one by one, right? So we all know that in the ecosystem that we are in, and we already have data protection bill, right, DPDP Act that we talk about. So data security will become very important part, and converging lot of capabilities for data security will become a very important area, and that's where the entire focus of security would be in coming future, right? Then hardware, because now attack vectors are increasingly focused on hardware. That's why security of hardware level becomes very important. Some of the data center had got these kind of problems. There is a super mini kind of a hack which was on one of the significant data center. The hardware Trojan was introduced there, and that's why hardware security will become very important part in coming future. IoT becoming important, that's why security in constrained environment will become very important part. And IoT, we know that power and the kind of a form factor available is quite significantly less. the edge computing and security at edge computing would become very important in coming future. The environment is so borderless, the security of a borderless environment and network will become very important in the future. We are going for more hyper-personalized computing so that the security of a privacy-enhancing computing will become very significantly important. The entire data operations, the security operations now increasingly data-driven operations, a lot of data is will be flowing to do the security analytics. That's why SecOps will become very important part. The distributed security computing, so nowadays we are increasingly using blockchain for cyber security, so distributed cyber security will become very important part. The overall human's role in cyber security will get debated quite significantly. If the volume and velocity is rising quite significantly, would the human intervention will be relevant in the taking security decision? That will be one of the important area of that. But from the data center perspective, the speed at which the traffic will be flowed, right? The ensuring security at high speed data transfer will be very important part, right? And as everything will become more software defined, how do you ensure security in software defined infrastructure will be very important part. App modernization will be very important. Data centers will be supporting those modernizations. So what will be happening for the security for when the applications are getting modernized? How can we bring, because we are now talking about the data center or computing facility available, makes the secure computing facility available to you basically. And data in use would be very important competence in the coming future basically. So the cryptology innovation like ZKP, modern crypto, the authentication, fraud management, such kind of element will become very important and they will bring a lot of those use cases for security research and innovation. Authentication for digitization would be very important part in coming future. As we are going for neuromorphic computing, brain response security will become very important part. As networks are becoming now 5G enabled, 6G enabled, the security of those networks will become very important part. Cloud security innovation, SCADA OT security innovation, and more importantly, developing quantum security stack and integrating that at a data center and providing those kind of capability will become very important part. So some of these areas that we are focusing attention from Data Security Council of India, and these areas needs a lot of those kind of effort, right? So those efforts will be required because some of those areas will require quite intense research intervention. They may not be possible in a commercial context basically. So there are entire research ecosystem where Government of India plus some of the private sector organization had been investing the research in cybersecurity research basically. Some of those areas will require a lot of innovation and new startups that need to be promoted, and we have been working to create this entire cybersecurity innovation ecosystem in the country. With the help of the Government of India, we already have a National Center of Excellence which has been set up to see some of these use cases can be picked up to develop the technologies and make them commercially available to the market basically. We also need to create a market for such kind of technologies basically. And all these entire capabilities that we have been creating digitization space, all this application that we have been developing, all the digital public infrastructure we talk about. So what we are trying to see, whether the security requirement of such ecosystem or such innovation happening in the country, can we create the security ecosystem, cybersecurity ecosystem in such a way that there are a lot of Indian capability, security capability available in the market basically, and in commercial sense basically. And that's what the effort that along with Government of India, we are putting together. So this effort would be going for next 2-3 years of time to build those capability and in these different areas that I talked about. This is kind of a agenda for innovation for cybersecurity that we are pursuing as a part of Data Security Council of India and as a part of overall cybersecurity ecosystem basically. And we like to see how we can contribute to the data center ecosystem that will be quite significantly different from now to coming 3-4 years of time basically. So with this, I would like to conclude my short talk on the how can we build security for the future of data center or future of digitization basically. Thank you very much.